Well, there's a growing concern about ultra-processed foods in American diets and their effects they have on our health.
Part of the problem, nutrition researchers say, is that a lot of healthy-seeming items, many breakfast cereals, soups, even granola, actually fall into that category.
Let's look at ultra-processed foods and their health risks with Dr. Zorba Pastor. Welcome back.
Good to be here.
Good to see you. What health risks do these ultra-processed foods?
First of all, let's look at, we've got regular foods like fruits and vegetables, raw foods. Then minimally processed foods, maybe you'll take carrots or vegetables and you roast them. And then we have foods that are processed, things like cheese, yogurt, milk products, things like that. And then ultra-processed foods are when you read all of the ingredients and you can't agree with all of them because you would never have them in your kitchen. Like maltodextrin, things to basically keep them, you know, totally together. And the thing about ultra-processed foods are this. They often have a combination of two things that do not occur in nature, fat and sweet. So in nature, you often do not have fat and sweet together. And when you mix them together, they somehow give you more energy in your brain and they become more addictive. And the studies have shown people eat ultra-processed foods more and more are much more likely to be heavier and heavier.
Yeah, it is. Well, it is kind of misleading because, you know, you're in the health food aisle and you're like, well, this should be good for me.
Right. Like granola?
Yeah, you look at a granola bar. The word granola is a great word. Like, it looks like it's going to be really good. But it turns out if you read the granola bar and you find out there are a bunch of things in it that you don't need, it becomes an issue. And I'll give a good example. I was looking at a couple of peanut butter jars. Uh-huh. So some say organic. But if you look at the back of the jar, it says organic, and then it has sugar in it, and then it has other oil, and it says to keep from caking. Well, peanuts have oil in them. So if you buy natural peanut butter, you got to mix it together like this. I know it's a lot of work to mix it together and put it down there. But the reality is, it's safer for you.
So look at the ingredients. The fewer, the better.
That's right. The fewer, the better. Michael Pollan came out a book with a number of years ago that said, if it's more than five ingredients, it's probably fake. That's not exactly right. But if you don't know what the ingredients mean, it's ultra processed. And if you look at the percentage of food that young children eat, it appears in America that about 60% of the kids in America eat ultra-processed foods every day. From granola bars, you know, running out and say, you've got to have something to eat, I'll give you a granola bar. That's ultra-processed for the most part, to basically frozen pizza and other things. So the answer is we've got to do something about it because it appears that obesity is not just caused by what we eat nutritionally, but whether or not it has ultra-processing in the processing of the food.
Well, one thing that I want to ask, you know, ultra-processed foods, they can be cheaper and lower-income families will turn to them because, unfortunately, fresh foods are kind of luxury items right now.
Can be expensive,
Is there a happy medium that people can use to stay on their budget but avoid some?
Ultimately, the happy medium, even canned foods, which are not ultra-processed, can be good. Frozen foods can also, if they're not frozen foods that are like, you know, any kind of a TV dinner, that's ultra-processed. But frozen fruits and vegetables can be just as good as fresh, and they can definitely be cheaper. Mm-hmm. And once again, but you've got to look at the label. If the label has too much in it, then that means it's ultra-processed.
So the Fritos got to go.
The Fritos have to go, and the Doritos.
Anything with an Eatos.
There's a new category. So have a good information as usual. Thank you.
Good to see you guys.